week, my nigga.
Yeah, do your thing. Joy not here, so I'm not going to do this shit today. Shout out to Joy.
Check. Hold on. We got our guests in here, man, so we can start up with some bars, can't we?
All right, cool.
We can start up with some bars, right?
Yeah, fuck it.
We can start up with some bars, right?
Yeah, let's do this. Lambo.
We can start up with some bars, right?
Give us some.
Hold on, you want me to get you one?
Spot on, fuck.
Hey, we going straight for the tech tonight. You want me to get you? Let me get you started. We're going to do it. All right.
Give us some spot, Lambo.
Hold on. Check. Hold on. Yeah. Check culture links. Check. Hold up.
You got some. Hold up.
When we pull up with a stick, Big Sip gon' hit. In this bitch with Lambo, yeah, we gettin' lit. Kimbing Slam on this bitch. Culture links 8 to 10. We finna get it in. Yeah. Y'all know what the fuck is about. Big Sip talking about what y'all talking about. Cut your nigga fast lag. Oh, let me stop playing. Hold on, Lambo. Let's get it, Lambo.
Hey,
let's get a Lambo.
And low. Yeah, you know how my fan works.
Hey,
yeah, you know how
it is. Lambo. Here we go, Lambo.
Get it in the fucking snow. Hey, in the fucking warm. In the fucking. Hey. In this bitch, yeah, you know I'm with the hustle firm.
Hey,
yeah. And we like the hustle, homes. Nigga, you don't know what the fuck we on right now. You don't know shit yet. Nigga, I've been on my grind getting big checks.
Yeah.
I've been doing this, I've been doing that. Yeah, I've been on my motherfucking grind, bitch.
Yeah.
I ain't stupid.
We got him in here off the cuff, man.
Yeah, culture links, ladies and gentlemen. Put him on a pressure.
You know,
welcome. You know what I'm saying? Welcome to Culture
Links. Welcome
to
Culture Links, man. You know, we ain't running right because we got goddamn already, yo.
Already, I want
to we gonna get it popping already. Go ahead, answer that, Perez. We go ahead and prep before we get.
They calling now.
What's going on, caller?
Culture Links. Culture Links. Hello? I guess they hang up. Anyway, back to the program.
All right, you ladies and gentlemen, this is Culture Links 8 to 10
I think I fucked up on our phone call. I fucked up big time. I turned the
phone. Each
man,
and every
too much Henny, yo.
Each and every Thursday, I go by the name Big Sip, a.k.a. Sipzell Washington, a.k.a. Two Titty. And when this bitch with prayers, we got our first guest, man. We're getting this bitch with Lambo, man. You want to answer that prayer?
Hold on. Culture Links.
Yeah, hello.
How you doing? What's the name? Where you calling from?
Yeah, this Trey Z Bravo calling from Baltimore.
What's going on with you? Who you want to talk to?
Is my man Tess in the building?
Yeah, he coming on 9 o'clock.
All right. I'm going to call back now.
All right. Sound good.
Back in there right now, too.
All right. Thanks for calling.
All right,
man. It's been another. What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? You good?
I'm good. Joy's not here.
Yeah, right.
We miss Joy.
Shout out to Joy.
Joy, bring a different energy to the table. You know what I'm saying?
We're going to have to muscle through. We're going to get through that. We professional. But what's going on, man? How was your week?
Great, man. How was your week?
Man, long, boy.
I kind of fell back. I've been resting a little bit this week. You know what I'm saying? I got a lot of shit going on. What you got going on?
No, man, you know, just working, man. You know how I do in these clubs every goddamn night, man. But, you know, I got stalkers and shit, cuz.
Oh, you was talking about what's going on?
Yeah, man. They done deactivated my goddamn Instagram and all kind of bullshit, yo. I got stalkers, yo.
Damn.
So shout out to my stalkers. Hopefully they listening. That's crazy. So I've been dealing with that bullshit. You know what I'm saying?
Probably one of your main girls.
Nah. It's for somebody I ain't even dropped no dick off in.
Oh, damn. Damn. That's crazy.
I feel like at this point in time.
You might as well.
At this point in time, I felt like I should have. You should have. Like, you know, I've been dealing with this shit for like 2 years, dog. This shit's crazy, yo. So shout out to all the bitches that ain't got nothing better to do with their time than bother my fat ass and shit. You ain't gonna get no money. Just want y'all to know I'm broke. I'm super duper broke.
That's crazy. Lambo.
Yo.
What's going on, man?
What's good with y'all?
What's going on, brother?
Thanks for coming out, man.
Appreciate you coming through, brother.
He been here before. He's part of the family.
Yeah, man.
Yeah. So, Lambo, what's going on, man? Who the fuck is Lambo, first and foremost?
It's young Lambo to the end, low, man. Grew up in Capitol Heights, Maryland, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Right by the south side, just, you know.
I see you with the CH, like proud, like big and proud. That's where your family, mom, pops, everybody from?
Yeah, basically, yeah. That's where everybody living at now.
Why you feel like you should wear the CH so big on your back and so like why you emphasize it so much?
This is my brand now.
Is it that deep in Cap Heights? Is it they behind you like that?
Uh-huh. Yeah, they love it out there. They sell out every week. I gotta get some more merchandise. Damn. Now.
You gotta get me, you know, get me swagged out one of them joints.
I got you.
I'm serious, dog.
I need one too.
Yeah, you should brought something with you.
Yeah, they sold out so fast. I was on my second shipment. Them things gone. I still got some more people asking for shit.
Lit.
So for our listeners, man, who is Lambo? Who is Lambo?
Lambo is just a young man, you know what I'm saying? Trying to make it out, you feel me?
Mm-hmm.
It's like anybody else. But just trying to influence the world as positively as I can through my music, you know what I'm saying?
How long you been doing music?
I've been doing music since I was like 14, 15.
Okay.
How old are you right now?
I'm 24.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So about 10 years. Yeah. Who were some of your influences?
I had a lot of influences. I mean, like my brother was in the Go-Go band, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
That was one of the influences. Go-Go was an influence.
Mm-hmm.
My father was like an old head for real. He was born in like the 50s. So I had that whole Motown era like bumping in the house sometimes, you know. My mother was real gospel like. She was listening to all gospel. It's a lot. I mean, rappers wise, it was like the old school rappers like Jay, Big, Pac, the Nas's, and all that stuff.
Who you listening to right now? You like in your car? Who you got in the deck right now? Or you see the player on your phone? Who you listening to right now?
I listen to anything for real. Like if it sounds good to me, I'm a rock with it.
So that new
Meek jump. I've been listening to
okay,
that.
Okay, wins and losses. Shout out wins and losses.
I gotta get hip to that.
Shout out wins and losses.
I've been seeing a lot of tweets on Instagram about that. I gotta get hip to that joint.
So let me ask you a question. As somebody who's being a younger artist in the hip hop game today with the mumble rap or the different alternative type of rap, with some of your influences being older people like Nas and Jay-Z. Jay-Z, of course, just put out the 444.
Mm-hmm.
What would you kind of rate your type of music? Like, would you?
See, I mean, I've been all over the place for real with the art, for real.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I give you like a bar for bar verse here, and then I go to the being the trap with my homies and shit, give you a mumble rap verse, and I give you an R&B song the next day. Mm-hmm. And then I give you a pop song right after that. Like, I'm very versatile when it comes to music, for real.
So you're not a rapper?
I wouldn't call myself a rapper, but I can rap though.
Yeah, but you're all around music.
You feel like
musician.
You're all around artist.
Yeah, musician as far as like you know, delivery and writing. Okay. You just an artist, musician all the way around. You play an instrument?
Yeah, I play instruments. I could play the guitar a little bit. Mm-hmm. I could play the piano. I could play a few chords on the piano.
Right.
That's about it.
So, we know you're signed, right?
Yeah.
Did they say why they signed you?
Who are you signed to, first of all?
I'm signed to Rostrum Records.
Okay.
Okay. And who's, for those who don't know, who's Rostrum Records?
Rostrum Records was the label that like took Wiz Khalifa career off and Mac Miller and shit like that.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Off in the early days.
Okay.
Yeah.
So more alternative, like hip hop, you know, not alternative, but Just different little stuff or whatever.
Yeah, it's just art. It's
all right, so you backed by a legendary, you know, DMV artist or whatever. He trying to, you know, stay cool, whatever.
Sure.
What is this pairing all about? Because he doesn't, you know, just come out for anybody. So please explain the relationship between yourself and Kingpin Slim.
Basically, Kingpin Slim just like showed me the ropes and shit, like how shit go. You know what I'm saying? Kept me on my toes. Keep me on my toes. Just keep me aware of things that I should be aware of that he already went through. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Basically, my OG. He's my OG in the rap game.
Right.
So
right.
Is it okay? I mean, King, can I ask you a question right quick, man? What is it about? Go ahead. Put on the headphones. What is it about? What is it about Lambo that you know attracted you to him? Because you're not just any old type of guy or any guy that's been here. You've been out here. You've been put out hits and you've been around here for a minute. What is it about Lambo that gravitated you to a new or younger artist like Lambo?
I feel like he can give me 10 years.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? I feel like he would have something to say for 10 years because he has an ability to illustrate his life in a way that's colorful enough for everybody to get it. Through his music, I feel like he got something to say. So
what do you feel like Lambo's greatest tool is?
His mind.
Okay.
His mind.
Okay. He's very versatile.
His mind for music. He's definitely versatile. He, like you said, he do a little bit of everything. He might sing you. He might rap you. He might mumble rap you. He kind of got a lot of different influences going on. They kind of put in his own little
twist to it.
Yeah, his own little melting pot.
Okay.
You know? So we know, like Sip said, you know, you're a legend around here, right? And you have seen a lot, many goals and whatnot, right?
Absolutely.
But as far as Lambo, like, you fully invested in Lambo. You know what I'm saying? I'm not talking about financially. I'm talking about time. You here, you know what I'm saying?
Here, just off the strength.
You're OG. Just here, even, like, giving him, giving it, for everything. You're giving him game, all that stuff. So, obviously, you believe in Lambo. Like, you, to me, it's like you're giving Lambo your life, pretty much. You feel me? You ever set back have any doubts?
Nah. I never had any doubts. I actually was like, this nigga's about to be out of here. That's how I be thinking. You know what I'm saying? Like, I really don't have no
doubts. Never one day in that conversation. I know y'all got disagreements, right? So,
not really. Because because it's not like, I mean, yeah, every now and then, if you're saying something to somebody they don't want to hear.
Right.
We don't be having no real disagreement.
Right. So how did you guys meet? How did you discover? Because I'm getting you discover Lambo, correct?
I mean, no, I wouldn't really say I discovered him. I can't take that credit. You know what I'm saying? I was put on to him from some other people. But what ended up happening was I had a studio uptown, and a lot of little dudes coming through the studio recording. And he was one of them dudes that was coming through recording. So he was dropping shit and the word was getting out that he was having some fire shit.
I was living in that joint.
Yeah, he was basically in that joint all the time. In other niggas' sessions, all hogging the mic.
Right.
So, nah, but yeah, he was there. And it was another artist that I liked. Really, I was really thinking about him. You know what I'm saying? And so, but he was getting on joints with him. And he was killing it too. And then I heard his own shit. Cause my homie Kofi put me onto it. He kept sending it to me. He was like, "You gotta listen to this shit." I listened to it. I was like, "Oh yeah, this shit is amazing." So that's how it was. Like,
what was the initial track that made you of his that made you be like, "Yo, that's you got it, shorty." Like,
probably I say his single "On My Way." Like this joint, okay. he had.
We gonna get into that in just a minute. So explain to us.
Excuse me for a second. I want to know, how you got signed or why they signed you. Why? Because, you know, I mean, I know why they signed you.
They signed him because he has a unique brand of music. And he has a way of making really big records. You know, he does that with ease. So they picked him up for that. They picking him up for his ability to make big records that translate.
Right.
The masses.
Right. So what is it? Well, what is the expectation right now as far as the single goes, right? This single is out right now, right?
Yeah.
Sip, we gonna play it right now, Sip?
We'll get to it. Go ahead.
Yeah, we gonna get to the single right now. What is the inspiration behind the single?
The inspiration behind the single was just being progressive, you know what I'm saying? Just being on your way to doing greater things than whatever you're doing now, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Everybody got a bigger dream than what they are now, you feel me? And just being on your way, just making sure you getting there, making sure you ain't letting the bullshit get to you.
How do you avoid the bullshit, especially right now in the DMV and this industry is a cutthroat industry, right? How you avoid the bullshit?
You stay out the way.
How you stay out the way?
You gotta do.
Especially you're very talented, right? So you know that comes with a lot of hate and all that good stuff.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? How do you avoid all the BS and keep, you know what I'm saying, putting out quality music?
You keep good vibes around you, you keep good people around you, and you gotta know how to read that shit. You just gotta know how to read between the lines.
Right.
And just.
So, Cap Heights, right? I know Cap Heights. I know what Cap Heights is about. Now, you say you avoid all that BS. How do you avoid, you know what I'm saying, the negativity and such like, you know what I'm saying? For those who don't know, who are listening probably outside of DMV or whatnot, Cap Heights is a neighborhood. It's not really like a regular suburb neighborhood. It's you know what I'm saying? It is what it is, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
There's a lot of stuff happening in Cap Heights. how do you avoid the negativity? You know what I'm saying? And like you said, they're behind you. So there's a reason why they're behind you. You know what I'm saying? There's some type of credit there. It's about respect. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
How do you avoid the negativity? And again, I kind of know you. I mean, I've been around you, talked to you. You know what I'm saying? So I never seen you like, you know what I'm saying, like sad or say nothing negative. You're always like up tempo. Mm-hmm. Like your spirit is always high. You feel me?
So, yeah,
you got it. And how do you maintain that? You know what I'm saying? That you're in a city or neighborhood that poverty, you know what I'm saying, killing, drugs, prostitution, all that good stuff. How do you, you know what I'm saying, maintain a high spirit?
You stay as positive as possible, and you be the positive influence that you want to see in your neighborhood. You got to be that. You got to live that. You got to think that way. You got to live that way.
Say, it's safe to say you're a leader, pretty much. You focus on leading the pack.
I first focus on being myself, you know what I'm saying? Making sure everything about me is authentic. Making sure I'm not faking, you feel me? If I'm down or if I'm feeling a negative way, I'm a get it out another way through art. Or I'm not going to get it out through violence or nothing, you feel me?
Yeah, right,
I'm going to try to make it as positive as possible, you feel me?
Cool. Respect. Yeah. That's good for the community, man. Mm-hmm. We'll get into the single tip. Lambo, go ahead and introduce the single.
This single right here is Lambo Anlo, On My Way, produced by Sean Nice, man. Rostrum Records.
Gang, gang, gang. Big Sip.
I'm on my way. Hey, wait, what? I'm on my way. Hey, wait, what? I'm on my way. Let it go to eight. That don't hold no way, but what you eat don't make me shit. I got greatness on my plate. It don't matter what's the day, everybody got a day. Until I reach my fate, I be on my way, I'm on my way. Ooh, I be on my way, I'm on my way. I be on my way, I'm on my way.
Hustle Firm Radio, Culture Links, Lambo in the motherfucking building.
Yeah.
One of DMV finest.
I like that joint, Lambo.
I co-sign this shit, you know what I'm saying? I've been telling Lambo he lit like a motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? Brother. I've seen Lambo, like, you know what I'm saying, fuck some shit up. Damn,
I fuck with that joint. Fuck with that joint, Lambo. That's good shit, cuz. That's good shit.
Yeah. So, Culture Links.
Hello.
How you doing? Where you calling from?
I'm calling from Capitol Heights. I'm trying to show some Lambo some support.
Say what's up to him.
What's good, broski?
What's good? You know what it says, brother?
This is my man, Lil Leeski. What it do?
What's up,
Jordy?
You did that radio so bad.
Yeah, bro. Appreciate you, man. Show some love.
Come on, bro. That shit ain't nothing, you hear me?
Always.
That shit ain't nothing.
You got a question for Lambo?
You said what?
You got a question for Lambo?
You got a question?
I got a question for you?
Yeah. You got a question for him?
Question. No, I ain't got no questions, bro. You know me, bro. I just wish you the best of luck with whatever you do. You hear me?
Appreciate you, bro. I love you,
man. I
ain't
got no questions.
All right, appreciate the love, bro.
I got expectations.
straight, just like that.
My nigga.
That way.
Hey, shout out to Hustle Farm for fucking with my mind, though, too, man.
Appreciate you, brother.
That shit ain't nothing, man. I appreciate y'all.
All right, man.
All right, man. Let's shoot some shit.
I want to talk about some personal shit. I want people like to get to know Lambo beside the music.
Yeah, I want to know Lambo.
What's
he already said he's from Capitol Heights.
Hold on,
let me ask this question first. Who's you rooting for? Would you fucking with Golden State or Cleveland? That's gonna
Cleveland.
Tell me
if you say Cleveland interview, you said Golden State, it's over.
That's gonna tell
me.
You a Cowboy?
I gotta break this down for y'all. The simple fact that KD from like right up the street from where I'm from.
Yeah, so.
So I had to see him get that ring, but honestly, it was.
What you think?
I was really on the fence, cause like, I'm always rooting for the underdog, just cause of, I don't know why.
What you think about this Kyrie LeBron situation going on right now?
Kyrie about to dip, cause
you think that's the right decision?
Yeah, he won't be a star, right?
You think that's the right decision?
Man, yeah, because Bron trying to little boy that man ain't no little boy. You feel me? That nigga's a grown man. And he got to go to, he got to do his thing. You feel me?
Mm-hmm.
He got to prove himself.
Mm-hmm.
All right, but what? I'm just saying. Yeah, I mean, so, I respect LeBron too, but I feel like he's just trying to keep taking them under the wing when it's
niggas and their egos be tripping.
It's, ego, yeah, it's all ego.
Niggas, why would I want to leave a team I'm already winning? That's like me, right? That's like we winning with Culture Links, right?
Right.
That's like me. All right, 2 years down the line, we done won a champion. Like we done won an award or something, going over somewhere else. Like niggas would feel some type of way.
But Bron probably I would not have gotten a championship. Like, you wouldn't have got no championship without me.
That may be true.
But Bron probably putting it out there like that. Like
what's wrong with saying that?
You wouldn't have got this shit without me. Like no.
What's wrong? It's a team. It's a team effort.
It's a team effort.
It's a team effort, yo. Go ahead. It's a team effort.
It is, though.
It's a big, big team. You a Redskins or go ahead. Go ahead. We got to call a caller, man. What's your name?
Links.
What up? It's Rick.
What up, Rick, man? Where you calling from, bro?
Cool. I'm from Silver Spring.
All right, man. Hey,
what up, bro?
What's up, Rick?
Cool.
That's Rick Flair.
Rick Flair.
What's up, bro? What up? Kingpin?
Nah.
That's Lambo.
That ain't Kingpin. Lambo, this is Prez,
King,
man.
Kingpin cooling out, man. Kingpin looks sleepy and shit.
Rick said, what's up?
Kingpin, what's up, Rick?
Hey, what's up, Rick? I'm trying to let Lambo get all the mic time. Yeah, I ain't trying to be on this, my man time.
Yeah, I'm saying? Kingpin, you know what I'm saying, sitting next to our star right now. Lambo going to fuck shit up, you know what I'm saying? And Kingpin just sit back and enjoy the shit. Pretty much, you know what I'm saying?
Pretty much.
Yeah.
But anyway, Bo, what's up, man? When the video come out?
Oh, the video? I don't really know the exact date, but I want to say like 2-3 weeks from now.
Mm-hmm.
Hopefully. Okay, so it's already everything already done and situated.
Nah, we got the first edit, but I think it's just a rough draft, so they going back over it. That thing official though, for sure though.
All right, my brother.
Shout out to Six and them. Shout out to Cool Kids Production.
Oh, man, you got some heavy hitters for the video. Yeah.
I mean, he fucking with Kingpin Slim.
Oh, you got some heavy hitters for the video. You ain't play no games for the video, cuz.
All right,
Rich.
Proud of you, man. Keep pushing, man. And thank you, bro. Don't get burned up in some 2K.
You some shit. I'm going to bust your ass. Oh, I definitely got a bunch of eyes. Now you trying to put me on black.
Who you run with in 2K? Who's had a 2K?
The Wizards.
All right, you know you can't use like Golden State.
Nah.
You can't use Golden State or Cleveland. You get an asterisk by your win if you use either one of those teams in 2K.
Nah, we going with Pacers before Paul George got traded.
Oh, okay. You some shit.
All right, Rick. Appreciate your call, bro.
All right, Rick.
You a Redskins or a Dallas fan, man? What's your expectation?
I'm a hometown player, dog.
All right, so man, what's your expectations for the year with the Redskins? Y'all can't keep cutting us up.
What the fuck we did last year? That's for sure. But I feel as though we could do it, man. Kirk got man. I'm behind Captain Kirk, man.
Let's talk about some real shit. I don't want a real conversation with you. You got a single out. That means something is coming. So we want to know what the fuck is going on.
What's up?
EP, album, mixtape. What's going on? What can we expect from you?
You know me. I stay in the studio.
I know you got materials. You know what I'm saying? But what the label talking about? So what they doing? What we got? What can we expect next from Lambo? We see you drop a single. Y'all pushing that. You know what I'm saying?
We taking it a day at a time, man.
I see. So you can give us something exclusive, like, you know what I'm saying?
We do got album coming, though. Album coming for sure.
Any idea, any expectation, date, time?
No, I don't got no date yet.
You want to give us nothing?
No.
You want to tell us the strategy meetings and shit? You want to tell us nothing? What the fuck? We want something.
It's just, we're going to work on the singles first. We're going to focus on the singles.
I see you got a newborn, right?
Mm-hmm.
You do, right?
Yeah.
How does that change your life?
A lot.
A lot? Yeah. But you're pretty young, right?
Mm-hmm. My man, 24.
Yeah, pretty young. So,
First of all, my respect for women went up to a whole nother level. I say that. And then, my respect for life, period, went up.
Mm-hmm.
And, just the focus that it gave me was, I'm a whole different person, for real, to be honest with you, mentally, I'm in a whole nother space now.
What kind of woman you like?
Kind of women I like?
Yeah.
I don't got no type.
Hey. You and Big Mom still good?
Nah, not really. I mean, we cool though.
How the bitches treating you? I think you say, I mean, you're single, right? You're new signing and shit.
I ain't single. You tell me to spark.
You're not single?
Nah.
Oh, damn, man.
Damn, bro.
You got Lambo, man. You fucking the game, man. You got sign and shit. You got to be single, man. You got to enjoy for a second, man.
Hey, like, man.
I mean, I've been getting a lot of hey, big head text lately, though.
I tell you what, man, just send them my way. All right, I got you.
I got you.
Until you, you know what I'm saying? You good to, like, you know what I'm saying? Take care of that. I got you, though. Just say yay prayers, man.
I got you. Y'all
could
get me in trouble.
Cousin that thing, girl.
So
yo, you finna go home and get your ass beat because of prayers, girl. God damn, boy. Miss Lambo, this is all radio. We doing this all for entertainment.
Media, it's all like, you know what I'm saying?
It's all for media.
Shit, you feel me?
You know what I'm saying? We just trying to create content. He ain't mean it.
So Lambo, I see you record an album. I see you was out of town and shit, right? Because I follow your Instagrams. So I kind of know what's going on, but I ain't know details, right? Mm-hmm. For the people who don't know, where did you record the album at?
Oh, the album got stuff from all over the place. I recorded the first two singles of the album in that studio we was just talking about.
Right.
And I mean, I really don't know everything that's on the album. I got so many songs. I got to narrow it down.
Right. Mm-hmm. How often do you write, though? Every day?
I try to write a song a day.
Damn.
I try to write a song a day. I write a song a day.
As a person who's familiar with just music in general, if you had a choice of any type of feature, who would be your main feature? Like, if you can, like, you know what I'm saying, map out your perfect record, your vibe or whatever, this is who I want to work with, new, old.
This is a lot.
All right, go ahead. Run them down.
But right now, I think.
Can you give us just two?
Give us three.
I want a DJ Khaled record, to be honest. I want one of them smash number one summer jumps. You mm-hmm. feel me? I think I could pull that off. But okay. I'm not really geeking to record with no other artists for real. I mean, I like the vibe. I mean, the vibe right and mm-hmm. the song right and it's cool. You feel mm-hmm. me? I don't really have a favorite artist right now.
Is it safe to say you're a personal person? You got a vibe with a person, then you like, let's do it.
Can say it's better that way. Okay. They don't gotta be that way. I could get it done regardless.
But you prefer to, like, you know what I'm saying, be more like a vibe thing versus like a whatever thing.
Yeah.
Cool. I respect that. That's dope. Artistry right there.
What's something about Lambo that your fans or people wouldn't expect from Lambo, just or about Lambo? Like a guilty pleasure, something you watch on TV or something you know you do. Not nothing crazy or nothing, but
I don't know. I put everything out in the open. I'm gonna say that right now. What you see is what you get.
If we listen to your music, can we find that information?
Hmm?
If we listen to your music, can we find that information?
What, a guilty pleasure or something?
Yeah, about, you know.
Are you that raw in your music where you put everything in, like, it's whatever, on my sleeve, my heart on my sleeve?
I don't do too much. I make music. I drink a lot. I might over-drink right now and then go through a binge stage or something. You feel me? I be fried.
What'd you like to drink, Hennessy?
Yeah, my binge is, I've been through a Hennessy stage. That's why I'm drinking wine now.
I've been trying to slow down,
get focused.
All right,
but
so,
I mean, that's about it. I don't do too much.
All right, cool. So, Lambo,
smoke weed.
Yeah.
All right, now that
I'm an advocate for weed smoking.
Kingpin's gonna be probably smoke all your weed and shit.
Yeah, wait.
Kingpin, you have that? Like,
Slim gonna roll up.
Yo, Kingpin, like, put over that bitch, zooted the whole motherfucking time. Cause he smoked that gab, boy. That knocked through and let it.
My tolerance for weed low, so
I ain't being interviewed.
I hit the J.
Yeah.
I hit the J one time. I'm probably about as high as a nigga who face one. I got a low ass tolerance for marijuana.
Damn.
I don't know why though.
So you're drinking?
I'm over drinking though.
That's cool. That's Prez ass. Prez alcoholic.
Yeah, I don't smoke.
I don't smoke at all. For real?
Nah,
I barely smoke.
I smoke, but like it's like I don't get it.
I want to smoke. Y'all tripping? I want to smoke all the goddamn time.
I don't get it. I don't get why people smoke.
To each his own.
Yeah, I don't get it. I'm like, give me something to drink and I'm cool.
Yeah,
I'm only drinking this Hennessy because it's something to do and it's free.
Respect. Yo, Sip is lying, yo.
Y'all can just all right, Lambo, man, before you get up out of here, man.
Yeah.
Let everybody know, first of all, where they can find you. You know, what you got coming up, what you working on. You know, getting shout outs out the way. Shout out to Bay Mom and all that, you know. Or, you know,
hey, man.
Say, bitch, you made it. Damn, say, fuck you, bitch. You can say it on air now, cuz. You can say it on air now, cuz. I'm on your side, my nigga. I'm on your side, my nigga.
Not that type of artist.
I'm gonna say, but you go ahead.
Basically, it's Young Lambo to the Anlo, man, coming straight out of Capitol Heights, Maryland, man. Go get that new single. On My Way on Spotify, iTunes, anywhere.
On My Way.
Coming soon. Shout out to Roshan Records. Shout out to New Wave Management. Shout out to everybody who supported the nigga and has come up. And just keep on giving the love, man. Love is love, man.
Yeah, and come back, man.
Peace, positivity, progress.
Don't be one of those artists who sign and get big and get $1 million check and be like, man, who the fuck is praying?
I feel like that's impossible.
Like, who the fuck is praying? Nah, come back, man. When you got something popping, just come back.
Definitely. All right? I appreciate you for having me.
No, thank you for coming through,
bro. Shout out to the Hustle Firm, baby.
Appreciate you, bro.
Yeah.
All right? And we at New Wave Rushing Record, Lambo, we out of here.